Hi friends, welcome back to my exclusive recipes channel. Today I'll be making the crispiest chicken sandwich ever. Each layer of this chicken sandwich brings its own unique and tasty flavor profile. Add them all together and you've got an unforgettable meal. A quick reminder before we dive into our recipe, subscribe to my channel. Just one click helps the channel in a huge way. Alright, let's jump in. We'll start off with prepping our chicken. Here I have 3 chicken breasts. Now, for any meat recipe, how you treat the meat decides how it turns out. Trust me, I'm not joking, it's true. To begin with, we'll slice open the chicken. Before slicing, make sure you have super sharp knife and super gentle hands. I'll quickly slice open the remaining 2. Let me come to an important point of treating the chicken. Each chicken breast has these patterns or threads which holds moisture. Intact threads results in juicy and tender chicken. If at all we break them while slicing, water content of the chicken reduces considerably while cooking, leaving this chicken hard and rubbery. So, we don't want to break this chain. Just slice it at a 45 degree angle along these threads. That's precisely what I mean by treating the chicken correctly. Next, I'll lightly season them with some salt and pepper. I'll flip and repeat it on the other side. Now, I'll break the process of coating into 2 steps. First, we'll coat all the pieces with cornstarch and let it rest. Cornstarch seals the moisture of the meat, resulting in juicy chicken. This also makes my entire coating process quicker and easier, as the next step involves working with a wet batter. This is the first layer of crunch, so make sure all the pieces are well coated. Now that all the pieces are well coated, let's move on to the next layer of coating. Here, I'll dip the chicken into a wet batter and then finally coat it with panko breadcrumbs. So let's quickly prepare a batter. For that, I'll use 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour and 1/4 cup of cornstarch. Season it with some salt and pepper. Next, I'll add in some water and give it a nice whisk. You can get more creative with this batter and add some paprika or chili flakes to make it more spicy, or even buttermilk instead of water. Here I've added around 1/2 cup of water. You can adjust it based on the size of the cup you have. What we are looking for is somewhere around this consistency. So let's start off dipping these pieces into the liquid batter and finally coating them with breadcrumbs. I'll repeat this step with all the pieces. You can freeze these at this point for later use. If you do so, remember to place parchment paper in between them. All my pieces are ready to be cooked. Let's move on to the frying area. I have preheated my oil at 340 degrees Fahrenheit and this chicken is ready to hop in. As I say, I'll fry them until GBD, golden brown and delicious. As soon as the chicken comes out, I'll place a cheese slice on top of it. This helps in melting the cheese and gives a nice gooey bite. Finally, let's put together chipotle mayo sauce. I'll use 1 spoon of spicy chipotle sauce and 2 spoons of mayonnaise. You can create your own combination based on your spice level. Finally, we are at the most exciting part, that is to put together the sandwich. Here I have this nicely toasted brioche bun which has sesame seeds on top. Brioche breads originated in France and are enriched with eggs and butter, which makes them ultra soft and delicious. They go perfectly with this sandwich. If you can't find them, regular breads work as well. I'll generously load it with chipotle mayo sauce and top it up with some lettuce. I prefer chopping my lettuce instead of using one whole leaf. This makes eating easier. It also prevents the leaf from slipping off while taking a bite. Next comes in some tomatoes and finally the delicious crispy chicken. I'll throw in the rest of the sauce on top. There you go, the best chicken sandwich is ready. Try this recipe and I guarantee you'll love it. Do give it a thumbs up if you like our video. Until next time.